Hello everyone, welcome to Falcon Informatics. In this video, I am going to show how to build your very own HAR cascade file for custom object detection. And you can see we have a lot of HAR cascade files here to detect the eye, cat face, front face. So we have a lot of HAR cascade files here. It's developed by OpenCV. And one more thing is, we don't have HAR cascade files for every object. So for example, if you want to detect a coconut or a green apple, means we have to create our own HAR cascade file to detect that object. I will explain that how to do that. First, we have to download one GUI. You have to use this website to download that GUI. This is how this GUI looks like. And I will post that website link in my description. You can get it from there. And scroll down to the bottom of the web page, and you can see a download option is there. And once you click download, start to download. After downloading, go to downloads. Here it will be available. And install this exe file. After installing that, it will be look like this. Okay, just open it. And this is how the GUI look like. I will come to this GUI later. First, I have to do some procedure in order to create our own HAR cascade file. So the first thing is, you have to create a new folder like this. The name of the folder is your wish. You can give whatever name you want. And after creating that folder, and inside that folder, you have to create two more folders. The name of the folder is N and P. And these folder names should be same as here what I mentioned, P and N. And don't give any other name. If you are giving any other name, means the GUI can't able to generate a HAR cascade file. So this is the important thing. And here, the meaning for P folder is positive image. And the meaning for N folder is negative image. In P folder, it has a positive image, and in N folder, it has negative image. What is the meaning for positive and negative images? We will call positive image as what are the objects we are going to do. In my case, I am going to detect green apples. So you can see, I provided all the green apple images as a positive image. So the reason is I am going to detect this green apple. And in the negative image, you have to specify the object that should be not detected by the program. So here I specified a human face and a wall, and it is not detected by the program if you are giving these images in N folder. And these are the explanation for these two folder. After creating these folder, and one more thing, if you want images like this, means just go to Google, and here if you need cat images, means just type Kaggle cat images dataset. What is the meaning for this Kaggle is, it is a open source dataset website. You can download images from there, and press enter. You can see cat dataset here. Just open that, and you can see n number of cat images here. By clicking download, you can download all these images, and you can copy these images to P folder. So that's all. And now I am going to explain the GUI part. Just to go to GUI, and here you have to change only two things. The first one is sample folder, and another one is this number of stages. Here in sample folder, you have to provide the path where you created a new folder. I will browse that, and it's available in downloads. And in downloads, so this is the folder I created now. So just to open that and click select folder. After selecting the path, just move to the next tab called common, and here we have to change only this number of steps. Don't change these values. If you are giving a higher value in number of stages, like 30-40, means it takes a lot of time to create the HAR cascade file, but it will improve the accuracy. And here if you are giving lesser values, like 15, means the HAR cascade file will be less accuracy to detect the object, and it takes less time. So I am giving a number of stages as 20. This is the default value. If you want to increase the accuracy of the object to be detected, means just give 30 or 35. But it takes a lot of time to create the hard cascade file, like 1 hour 30 minutes like that. And after that, just move to cascade folder. Here you have to change these two, and here these are the default values. If your image size is too large, means just change the width and height according to that, or else you can use the default value for creating the hard cascade file. And after changing these values, just click start to create the hard cascade file. And it's showing like creating positive list. So this is how it will create the hard cascade file. It takes some time. And one more thing, don't run any other software while you are doing this task. It will crash both the software. So that's why I'm saying this. And finally it rained. Now close this GUI, then open this folder, and new folders and files are created by that GUI. Just open this classifier, and you can see this is the XML file that is created by that GUI. I'm going to rename that as Apple. After renaming that XML file, I am going to copy that and paste it here. And I have one program to detect custom objects. Just I'm going to paste it here. And if I am opening this program, means so this is the program for detecting custom objects with the help of hard cascade. And you need to specify the XML file here, the name of the XML file, that is apple and .xml. After doing this, what you have to do is just run this program, and you can see now I'm going to show the object. So this is the green apple. It's detecting very accurately. This is how this works. Now I am going to close this window. If you have any doubts or any queries, means please let me know in comment section. I will clear that. Thanks for watching. Keep supporting us. Thank you.